Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and entertaining simple. In this video, I'm going to show you the items that I have in my small 2-week prepper pantry. So I have been prepping for a few years and I've learned a lot of things from different prepper channels. I'm gonna put the links of their channels in the description box below. They're ones that I have really learned from. They explain things very well. And all of this is because of things that I've learned from those channels. First of all, this is all laid out to show you what it takes to fill up food for just 2 weeks for a family of four. Now, our son is vegan, so a few of the items here are not for him, or a lot of the items are not, but he does have his own stash for the things that he eats. If you're vegan, can you comment below and let me know some other things that I can put in my prepper pantry for my son? I don't sprout seeds and I don't have a garden, so I need some more ideas and I'd appreciate it a lot. So I say this is for 2 weeks, so how do I know that? Well, all of these items are things that we actually have eaten or eat. Now, of course, there are things that we don't eat all the time, for sure. We don't always eat Spam or corned beef. They're actually things that are a treat for us. We are Filipino, so Spam is life, so it's actually a treat. And since I've cooked it in the past, I know that it takes 2 of these cans of Spam to feed the 3 of us, my husband, my daughter, and me. So this would be 1 meal, another meal, another meal, another meal. So those are 4 meals already. For the corned beef, it takes 2 cans to feed the 3 of us for 1 meal. So 1, 2, 3, 4, that's another 4. So now those are 8 meals. That is a week's worth of dinner. Of course, you wanna have variety. So you're not gonna be eating hopefully the same thing every night, but if that's what you have, then that's what you have. So you wanna add variety. Example, throw in some vegetables like corn and carrots, or some fruits like peaches and pears. And then maybe you wanna add in some soup, okay. Another thing that we have here are Vienna sausage. So 2 of these stacks is 1, 1, and 1. So now you have 3. And then here's another one, another one. So 8 plus 3 is 11, plus 2, that's 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. And then now let's go on to the pasta. 1 box of spaghetti and 1 can of pasta sauce is enough for the 3 of us. If my son is going to be eating it, it's not going to be enough. So we'll probably add 2, okay? So that's already 21 meals, 22 meals. And then with that, again, you could throw in some of the snacks. You could even have, let's say, mashed potatoes and gravy. When you have one of those meals there, you want to find things that you just have to add water or are very simple to prepare. Without water would be great. If with water, then not, you know, not something that requires a lot of water. I do have 2 camping stoves with butane that is enough to cook meals for a month. Okay, and they're not like big fancy meals, just small meals. I have my cooking oil. And then we are definitely ketchup people, so I have ketchup there. And so now we are at 22 meals, right? So now you can throw in some ramen, okay? These are not gonna be fancy meals. You can make them fancy. You can add peas, maybe you still have some eggs that are good. You could throw in some eggs. This is a 12 pack. So there's like 3 of these would make a meal. So now these are 4. So now we're at 26 meals, and then throw in maybe peanut butter and jelly or some soup, and now you're at 28 meals. So 28 meals is 14 days times lunch and dinner times 2, that equals 28. So that's how I know that this is 2 weeks worth of meals for my small prepper pantry. Let me show you the other things that we have here. I am very conservative with saying that it's 2 weeks because we can also add this mac and cheese. We can add this rice-a-roni. We also have here SpaghettiOs and ravioli. So that is going to be more than the 28 meals, but I like to keep that conservative and include it in the 2 weeks in case one of the meals we're just like extra hungry and maybe we're just stressed out and we feel like we need to eat more. You want to have a variety here with the sauces for pasta, maybe some Alfredo and some pesto. And again, things that your family would normally eat. I want to share a caveat. Before you stock up and do your prepper pantry, remember the number one most important is water. You've heard it, 1 gallon of water per person per day. So that is 4 of us, plus our dog Molly, she's a dachshund, so 5. 5 gallons per day to provide for my family. Times 14 days, that's going to be 70 gallons of water, okay? And it's more than you think it looks like. When I started prepping, I was like, wow, this looks like a lot of water. But really, go through a gallon of water in 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. You've got to practice it and you'll see, yeah, it does make sense when they say 1 gallon. My water is stored in another area, but we are set for 2 weeks worth of water. I do want to add to my water supply. So here we have a bunch of snacks. We love to snack. We have chips and salsa, peanuts, nuts, mixed nuts, some dried fruit, crackers like Wheat Thins and Triscuit, Cheez-It, chicken and biscuit, and some dried fruit and a little bit of dessert like with this pudding and Oreos, some applesauce. And when you are like anxious or stuck in the house, you're sheltering in place, salty and sweet are good things to have on hand. Now, we're not big breakfast people, but I do have here cereal. My daughter does like cereal once in a while. We do like oatmeal. So we have there, I wanna add to my breakfast and oatmeal stash. And then we have here some milk that is shelf stable. Our family's lactose intolerant. So we have rice for my daughter. She's allergic to nuts, so she cannot have the almond milk. That's for my husband and my son. And then definitely have some trail mix and some Clif bars or protein bars. Those are really good snacks, or they can be a meal in and of themselves. And then I have to have my Coca-Cola. I do need to get some LaCroix or bubbly water. They're supposed to be here, but we used it up. And it's nice to have a different type of drink aside from water, just a few times. You don't wanna, you know, go overboard because you do need the water, actual water, to keep you hydrated. Okay, I have some beans here because these beans, I could add it for the rice-a-roni. And then we have some potatoes. Of course, those can go with the main meals. And then I have these Annie Chuns. They were only $2.46 at Walmart. These are different varieties. They are vegan, so it's a great thing to have for those who are vegan in your household. Okay, I had to lay it out because it's hard to do this with one hand. So meat and fish, pasta and rice, fruits and vegetables, snacks, breakfast, cooking and condiments. I'll probably add their cooking and condiments and cola, so drinks. Okay, I just have this plain clipboard, use rubber bands to attach a pen, and then what I did was to add the item contents, the size, so how many ounces, and then the quantity. Use by, so this is important, instead of looking at every, you know, turning it, trying to find the expiration date, then finding the expiration date for this, every time you look into your pantry, it's nice to have it all laid out. So that's important, so you can see a lot of these, most of them are good for a year or more. There's some stuff that are expiring in 6 months, so I also put here under notes is where I bought them, okay, the brand, and then where I bought it. It's easier to remember things when you just write it down. For me, the memory of a pen and paper is better than my own memory. As I said, I decided to print these, but you could definitely write it. This took about an hour and a half to go through all this stuff and put it in here and the typing. So it might be faster if you handwrite it. Now I have a pen here because if I add stuff, I could just write it here. And then when I actually use things, example, let's say we cooked 2 of the Spam, you cross it off. So you make sure you cross it off from the bigger number versus the smaller number, because now once you cross this off, okay, just pretend I cross it off. Oh, let me find something that I actually used. Okay, I actually used one of the creamy peanut butter the other day. So you take this, the 16 ounce, I think it was, and then you just cross it off like that. So now when you look at it, you see these cross marks. Okay, you know that you're out of that. And then you can replenish it if it was something that was good. If not, you can replace it with something else. As I said, this is a 2-week pantry, but it could be a 2.5, 3 week if we stretch it. So when I start crossing stuff out, you know, I'm not gonna be like so anxious that, oh no, I only have this much of this. I need to go run out and replenish it. It will give me a week to replenish this. And remember also that you have your freezer, your fridge, your regular pantry for food to use. If your electricity goes out, go ahead and start using those, especially the things in the freezer and fridge. Eat through that first, and then this is like a short-term food backup. This clipboard actually has this, so you could hook it onto something on the wall. So I just have a command hook, and I just place this clipboard with the inventory sheets right there on the wall where my prepper pantry is. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought would never pay the price.